Well, hey, you guys, this is David Bush, and I'm so excited to bring you one of our nurse health coach success stories. And today I get a chance to interview Norma Millard. She has got an amazing story on how she transitioned from an extensive career as a nurse into a thriving opportunity to help others to create health in their life as a certified health coach. So Norma, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you, David. I'm so happy to have this opportunity to share.
Yeah, well, we love celebrating success stories of those nurses that have made the successful transition into the wellness and the preventative care industry of health coaching. And so today I'd love to have you share a little bit of your background and your story. Why don't you just share the viewers today a little bit about kind of how you got started in nursing and a little bit about your professional experience?
Okay. I wanted to be a nurse for as long as I could remember. And actually, I can pinpoint it to when I was 7 years old. And I was introduced to a woman who became my sister-in-law. And she just, for me, she epitomized everything that a nurse was. Just her personality, her kindness and gentleness and caring, plus the white starched uniform and all that. So that was my image. So I all through school, that's all I ever talked about. And I got into high school, started applying to nursing schools because I had no plan B. That was it. No other option. And because of a medical issue that had been diagnosed in childhood back then, in the early 60s, they wouldn't accept me in the traditional nursing schools. So of course that was a shock. It was heartbreaking. And so I had to move on. I went to college for a year. I got married. I had three amazing children and loved being a mother. But when they got into school, I went back to school. That dream was still there. That's all I could think of to do. So some non-traditional programs were available for adult learners. I got my associate degree so I could practice right away as soon as possible, got my license. And then I went on to get my bachelor's and eventually graduate degree. I lived in a tiny little town in Colorado, mountain town, and we essentially had to care for whatever came in the door. So I experienced everything from the delivery room to through the lifespan and basically all different types of deaths. I then really got into hospice and spent 25 years providing end-of-life care. So that was kind of the span of my nursing.
Yeah. Well, then you kind of hit a tumultuous time in your life after 25 years in hospice. Tell us a little bit more about that transitional time that really kind of awoken you to the life that you were living and what you were fully capable of.
Okay. Yeah. Obviously, during that time, I was surrounded by the effects of all of these terminal disease processes that were going on. It was wonderful to be able to support families and provide comfort for patients, but it was very draining because I felt like there really should have been so much more I could do as a nurse. And you don't fix them, you comfort them, you know, which was great. But then when I retired, I ended up taking care of my mother and my husband for the next couple years until they passed away. During that time, I realized that I had been taking care of people all my life pretty much, but I wasn't taking care of me. Those hospice days were long and hard, you know, bad habits, grab something to eat when you could. Often it was the wrong kind of stuff. Go home, finish documenting, grab something for dinner, fall into bed and exhausted and not getting a whole lot of exercise or anything. And I'm sure everybody out there can identify with that. About that time, about a year after I retired, I met a wonderful woman who actually became my health coach. I was desperate. I had to make changes. I couldn't do what I needed to do for my family unless I had a healthier body and mind and just outlook myself. My lab work was not good. And she introduced me to this amazing program that was unbelievably easy to follow. She walked with me every step of the way. And this being physician-led, it was something I could really identify with and grab onto. And then the community of people that surrounded me for support was absolutely amazing. And after a year or so, I just could not believe all the changes in my life. My lab values were perfect. I lost a fair amount of weight. My mental clarity and focus was so much better, more energy than I had had for many, many years. And actually, able to handle stressful situations better. I mean, just a life that I hadn't had since I was a kid, probably, that I could recall.
Yeah. Well, we have so many of the nurses that we come into contact with that have spent years sacrificing their health and their well-being for the care of their patients and their family members and their mm-hmm. friends, where the idea of focusing in on them is somewhat foreign to them, and to actually have a person that walks that journey and supports them as a health coach is oftentimes, you know, misunderstood to a certain extent until they actually experience it and they see that it's not really, a health coach doesn't necessarily tell you what to do. It's more about the awakening and helping you to discover what you want to do, what you want to be, what you want to have, and then to help you to take the steps to adopt the habits of health to do that. So you went through the health coaching program, you experienced the benefits of it, which is so common to the coaches that come through our program, and then you decided to share that with others. How did you make a decision to enter into the field or specialty of health coaching?
I couldn't help it. I said no a couple times. I just thought, I'm not sure if this is what I want to do. I thought maybe I was done with nursing completely. And but I was so thrilled with my own changes. And I just naturally wanted to pass it on. I had to. I knew too many people that needed what I had found.
Well, as a nurse who worked as an employee and who, you know, did nursing for so many years, I'm sure you were a little bit fearful or maybe a little bit timid or uncertain about what it meant to be an independent entrepreneur that ran your own health coaching practice. How did you get over some of those fears, Norma?
Well, my coach started me on that path by introducing me to ways of sharing it. I modeled what she had done, and the training that I received was wonderful because it was step by step, encouraging me to go at my pace and learn things as I could. And you know, I was older; it takes me a little while for things to sink in, but it was just so easy to share. Because it was just a natural result of what was going on in my own life.
Yeah, and there's many nurses out there that are already healthy that don't need to go through a transformational experience before they start paying it forward. But most people can go through the program and experience some sort of benefit the way that you did and have their own story. And it doesn't have to be weight loss. It can be that clearer thinking or that great awakening to the idea of creating health in your life, rather than managing disease or trying to lose weight. So it's great to hear stories like yours where you adapted those habits and then you started paying them forward. Talk a little bit about your daily life in the world of health coaching, because you do health coaching on a part-time basis. Is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
So talk a little bit more about what that looks like on a day in, day out basis, and how many hours do you devote to your coaching business?
Well, because I have so much freedom, I have the control over what I do and when I do it, because I schedule my life and then work in the coaching, you know, and it's fabulous, but there's such a beautiful balance there. And I would say 5 to 10 hours a week, and that includes a lot of personal and professional development type things. And right now I have about 15 active clients, which is comfortable for me. If I want more, I work harder to do that. And if for some reason I need to back off a little bit, that's in my control. I make that decision as to what my business is going to do. But it's so much fun, because these people that have these same chronic diseases that I dealt with so long in hospice, they're amazed when a few little things that I have to offer them make such a big change in their lives. And there's nothing better than that. And
yeah.
Now I really, really have a passion for helping others to start their own coaching business, and reaching out to other nurses now, because I think it's the optimal nursing career, and it's in a fabulous way to be retired.
Yeah, well, we talk a lot about, you know, nurses want flexibility, balance, and purpose, and this health coaching opportunity gives them an opportunity to discover that more for themselves on a personal side, just getting healthier and becoming more aware of their health habits and their patterns, and helping them to create goals and focusing in on themselves as well as their family to start prioritizing their time a little better. And health coaching, you know, can start off in your spare time, and it can grow into a full-time career opportunity.
Absolutely.
So it's great to see the fact that this has become an encore career for you and so many others, that's brought some hope and health into your life, and that you're out there on the mission to not only get people healthier, but to awaken more health professionals and nurses to the opportunity that health coaching provides.
So absolutely. I'm living the dream. That 7-year-old, yeah, I'm living that dream.
Well, that's the mental benefits of being a health coach. You know, as a nurse, we have so many of us are spending time helping people to survive, or helping people just to continue on with their current existence, where in this business of health coaching, you're actually helping people to thrive in their life. And when you see others thriving around you versus just surviving or dying, it becomes an enlightenment to the fact that you're becoming more significant. And not to take anything away from what nurses do, but there's this opportunity to give life to people. And so it's so so wonderful that you're able to do that, Norma. And thank you so much.
It gives me more my motivation for me, keeps me really, really accountable too for my
very own true. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for sharing your story with us, Norma. And we appreciate all you're doing to get America healthy.
Thank you, David.
All right. Have a great day, everybody.